awakes to the bells of Notre Dame.
The fisherman fishes,
the baker man bakes,
to the bells of Notre Dame.
To the big bells as loud as the thunder,
to the little bells soft as a song.
And some say the soul of the city is the toll of
the
were both taken in by the grace of Notre Dame.
Claude the older, who cared for his brother,
young Jean, full of beauty and charm.
And they lived and they grew and awoke to the music of bells. The bells of Notre Dame.
Brother, 'neath these arches and this sacred hill, we are blessed to find our sanctuary and our home.
Righteous Claude Frollo was evermore drawn like a son to Notre Dame.
Not like his profligate brother Jean, who'd have none of Notre Dame.
Though as brothers they loved one another,
Frollo watched in despair and alarm. As Jean grew more wild and defied, and defiled all the laws.
The laws of Notre Dame.
You must leave, Jean, this holy refuge where you've dwelled.
Leave, but father!
Sorry, Claude, but I've no choice. Your brother is expelled.
And Frollo didn't hear from his brother for several years.
Meanwhile,
Jean, let me take you back. I'll bring you home.
Brother dearest, come with me where we will find a remedy, and Notre Dame once more will be your sanctuary. Healing you will be my goal, not just your body, but your soul. We'll be together in our holy sanctuary.
Within.
Bring these gypsy vermin to the Palace of Justice.
You there! What are you hiding?
Stolen goods, no doubt. Take them from her.
She ran.
Enough, Claude! It's too late for me anyway. But if you've truly discovered charity at this late date, there's someone you can help.
This is an unholy demon. I'm sending it back to hell, where it belongs.
See there the innocent blood you have spilled on the steps of Notre Dame.
I am guiltless. She ran, I pursued.
Oh, you would add this triumph blood to your guilt on the steps of Notre Dame.
My conscience is clear.
You can lie to yourself and your minions. You can claim that you haven't a qualm, but you never can run from or hide what you've done from the eyes, the very eyes of Notre Dame.
It as your own.
What? I am to be saddled with this misshapen.
Very well. But let him live with you in your church.
Live here? Where?
Anywhere. Just so he's kept locked away where no one else can see. The bell tower, perhaps. And who knows, our Lord works in mysterious ways. Even this foul creature may yet prove one day to be of use to me.
A baby? Yours? Oh, a monster. It's God's judgment on you. The wicked shall not go unpunished.
I should have known. I was a fool to think that you would look after him.
Look after him, me?
He has nobody else. Take him. If you can find it in your heart.
Cheon. Cheon! Oh, Lord. You've sent me a test. This child is my cross to bear. I may not have saved my brother, but I will save this thing.
See this loathsome creature from whom lesser men would flee. I will keep and care for him and teach him at my knee to think like me.
And Frollo gave the child a name.
A cruel name that means
half-formed.
Quasimodo.
Now here is a riddle to guess. If you can sing the bells of Notre Dame.
What makes a monster and what makes a man?
What makes a monster and what makes a man?